Father, while you're revealing yourself to others, please don't pass me by tonight. Father, I don't want to miss that heavenly visitation. If it's your prayer, you can signify by raising of your hand. Whatever need, whatever requests you have, it can be made known to him tonight. He is able. He is within reaching distance. He is a high priest that can be touched by the feelings of our infirmities. We can speak to him tonight. We can touch him tonight. The singer say, touching Jesus is all that really matters. And your life will never be the same again. Father, we come before your throne of grace tonight. We thank you, Father. Our hands are raised. Mine is up also. Father, under expectation. Father, expecting to meet with you. We have not come to see a man. We have not come to hear the pastor preach. Father, we know there is nothing good that can come out of a man. The words of men are death. Father, man himself is a subject and attribute of death. He is veiled in a dying body. Father, so there is nothing good that can come from man. Lord, that's why we are depending on the unfailing hand of Jesus Christ, Father. Father, may you come, Lord God Almighty, tonight and help us not to lean on our own understanding, Father, but to lean on that unchanging hand. Father, may you come in our midst tonight, heal the sick, deliver the bound, set the captives free. Lord, bring such a revival spirit. Bring a spirit of rejuvenation in our hearts. Bring us closer to you, Father. Just a closer walk with you. That is all we need, Almighty God. And we need you to come, Father, and to break the bread so that we can see you in the breaking of the bread, so that our eyes can be enlightened, so that our eyes can be awakened, Father, to the reality even of your word, of the message of the hour. There are hands that's been raised in your house, oh God. There is a need, there is a request, there is a question, there is a desire. Father, that is signified and symbolized by every hand that has gone up tonight. Father, I pray that you supply every need, answer every question, heal the sick in our midst. Father, I want to pray that you forgive the sinners. Oh, mighty God, we have been rubbing our shoulders with the world, and part of the world rubs off on us, oh God, and we end up having a spirit of heaviness. Oh God, anti-praises and anti-worship demons, Father, I bind them tonight in the name of Jesus Christ. I take every negative spirit, every spirit that is contrary to the preaching of the word, Father, I take it and I put it under my feet for the glory of thy name. I am praying this evening time, Lord, for your people. Touch your people once again with your precious holy hand. May we experience your grace. May we experience your power and your presence. Even in our lives, we pray in Jesus' mighty name. Amen and amen. Amen. Are you happy?
Amen.
I greet you in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. If you don't mind, let's stand upon our feet. Amen. And just read the scripture tonight. It's good to be in the house of God. Amen. We're just so much under expectation.
Praise the Lord.
How many under expectation?
Amen.
How many under expectation?
Amen.
anointed service. Thursday services are more anointed than Sunday services. Amen. But also these are the services that the devil fights a lot.
Amen.
Because we'll be coming with heaviness from home, you know, the pressures from Monday, you know, the pressures from work. The boss was fighting with you, the kids were troubling you, things were not going the way you want them to. But we want to move away from that anointing and get into the anointing of the word. Remember we said everything is about atmosphere. Amen. Praise God. Amen. So we want to open our Bibles to the book of Exodus. Exodus chapter 3. We want to continue with our Bible studies. Amen. You will see that there's so much that we could speak on these subjects. You know, a lot of things are just breaking forth, and I was saying, Lord, I've never been so disorganized like I am today. I have a lot of things that I feel we can share tonight. You know, by the grace of God. And I believe you give us grace, you know, just to bring the pictures, the broken pieces, and you know, make a rose glass out of it. Amen. Exodus chapter 3, from verses 1, the Bible reads, "Now Moses kept the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of Midian, and he led the flock to the backside of the desert, and came to the mountain of God, even to Horeb." He didn't know yet that this is the mountain of God.
Amen.
Amen. But he is led by sheep to the mountain of God.
Amen.
"And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush." I want you to see the angel of the Lord is the one that is appearing unto Moses. Amen. "And he looked, and behold, the bush burnt with fire, and the bush was not consumed." Let's bow our heads.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, we have read what we believe to be your word. Any educated man can open the pages of the Bible and say something about it. But it takes your spirit, Father, to anoint these words to become spirit-filled spoken words. Lord, let them be life to us tonight. I pray that you anoint this scripture, Father, and make it alive to us. Make it relevant in our lives. Make it relevant in our day and age. Father, it is my prayer tonight. Bless your people. Bless us in the hearing of the same. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray, believing. Amen and amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. Amen. Amen. We're going to continue reading. Amen.
Amen.
I just made you sit so that you don't get to stand for too long. Amen. Because I'm going to go down with that scripture. But I don't intend to take much time. So I want to preach tonight on showing Moses in the 20th century. Amen.
Amen.
You know the Moses of the Old Testament. We want to show him in the 20th century. In other words, we want to show him in this day. Amen.
Amen.
And I want to take for a subject, that's my title, Moses in the 20th century.
Amen.
And for a subject, I want to say, the messenger unrecognized.
Amen.
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 Tonight we're going to be showing who is the real messenger.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Because many a times we take on an attitude, you know, against Brother Branham. You can disrespect the vessel. You can disrespect the outward man. You can find fault in the way he died. You can find fault in his English. You can find fault in a lot of things. You can find fault in his background, how he was half Irish and half Cherokee. He was a half breed. You know, you can find fault in his habits as a man. In the body. That's why he says, "I am a sinner saved by grace." But tonight we want to see who was the messenger.
Amen.
Who was it? Who is it that we are being said we should believe upon?
Amen.
Who is it that we are being compelled to be believers in?
Amen.
Moses in the 20th century.
Amen.
The Bible says the angel of the Lord, verses 2. The angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burnt with fire, and the bush was not consumed. This is Moses looking at a natural bush, but there is a supernatural fire. It's burning, but it's not consumed. There is something phenomenal about this bush. Amen. And Moses said, I will now turn. I want you to see. I will now turn aside and see this great sight. Yes. Why the bush is not burnt. Right. In other words, the bush was always present.
Yes, sir.
The bush was always burning.
Amen.
But it had to come to a point where Moses says, I will now turn.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Amen. It's showing that he was passing by.
Amen.
But something got his attention.
Amen.
Having been a prince in Egypt,
yes,
he knew all about science.
Yes.
He knew all about mechanics and chemistry.
Amen.
So now he's seeing a spectacular. He knew fire. The component of fire is burning.
Yes.
But here is a bush that is burning,
yes,
but it's not being consumed.
Amen.
And then he says, this has attracted me.
Amen.
The attraction is not the bush.
Praise
the attraction is the fire.
Amen.
That is on the bush.
Yes, sir.
And that fire, we know what it is. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
We know that fire. Mm. And when the Lord, now I want you to see verses 4.
Yeah.
On verses 2, it says the angel of the Lord.
Yes, sir.
The angel of the Lord appeared and said unto Moses. That's verse 2. The angel of the Lord appeared. But on verses 4, it says, and when the Lord saw.
Yes.
I thought it was an angel.
My. Praise the Lord.
It's not an angel.
Amen.
This is the Lord himself.
Amen.
So you see, God can be called the angel of the Lord.
Amen.
God can be called the Lord.
Amen.
God can be called Jehovah.
Amen.
God can be called the pillar of cloud.
Amen.
God can be called the pillar of fire.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you have to understand the appearance of God.
Amen.
For you not to be able to blaspheme, I'm going to show you.
Amen.
You can easily blaspheme when you don't understand who it is.
That's correct.
So the Lord saw that he turned aside to see. And God called him out of the midst of the bush and said, Moses, Moses. So the Lord knows you by name.
Amen.
Remember that song?
Amen. He knows my name. He knows my every thought.
Amen.
Amen.
He knows my name.
Amen.
He knew this was Moses. Moses, Moses. And he said, here am I. And he said, draw not nigh hither. Put off thy shoes from off thy feet. For the place whereon thou standest is holy ground. On Sunday we're showing the same angel appearing to Joshua. And he said, now am I come as captain. Do you see what I'm saying? It's the same Lord that spoke unto Joshua and said, as I was with Moses.
Yes.
But now he's appearing as captain.
Amen.
And when he appears as,
yes,
it shows he's appearing in a form that he did not appear before.
Correct.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Amen.
And he had a drawn out sword. And Joshua said, on whose side are you? Are you on our side? He says, I'm not identified with the camp. I'm not identified with the people. I am come as captain of the Lord's host.
Praise the Lord.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Wonderful.
Amen.
Beautiful.
So he tells him the same thing. Joshua is told to lose one shoe, but Moses, both of your shoes, take them off.
Yay.
Amen. On verses 6 says, moreover, he said, I am the God of thy father. Now I want you to see. And the God of Abraham, the angel of the Lord. Verses 2. And the Lord, verses 4. Verses 6. Now he is coming out in the plain. He says, I am the God of your father.
Amen.
The God of Abraham.
Yes.
The God of Isaac. The God of Jacob.
Amen.
And Moses hid his face.
Amen.
Hallelujah. All this time he's looking at it directly. But when he reveals who he is,
amen,
Moses starts hiding his face.
Amen.
He says, I don't want to see God.
Amen.
I'm afraid to look upon God.
Amen.
Identifying himself with Abraham, the God of Abraham. Who is the God of Abraham? Elohim.
Amen.
The one that visited Abraham in the plains of Mamre.
Yes.
Who is the God of Abraham? Jehovah Jireh.
Yes.
The one that created the ram in the thicket.
Yes.
Amen.
Who is the God of Abraham? Melchizedek.
Yes.
Amen.
The one that he met after the slaughter of the kings.
Amen.
Come on, say amen.
Amen.
This is the message of the hour.
Right. Amen.
He's saying, I'm Elohim.
Oh, ma.
I'm Jehovah Jireh.
Oh, yes.
I'm El Shaddai.
Amen.
Ma. I am the one. I am he that created the heavens and the earth.
Yes, amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the angel that is talking about here.
My God.
The angel of the Lord appeared to Moses.
Amen.
This is not a created angel.
Hallelujah.
This is a creating angel.
Yes, sir. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
This is an angel.
Yes.
That speaks things into existence.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And the prophet says, the same angel that created the ram in the thicket is the same one that created the squirrels.
Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Who is the messenger?
My God.
The messenger in this generation, unrecognized.
Amen.
We are living in a generation of desensitized people.
Correct. Amen.
We don't know what we believe.
My God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The prophet said, the same angel that created the ram.
Yes.
He's the same angel.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
That spoke the squirrels into existence.
Yes, sir.
The same angel that led Moses up the mountain to meet with the angel.
Praise the Lord.
He's the same angel that led William Branham to the cave.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
1946, 7 May, Green's New, he goes into the cave.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
He's not going there to meet with the angel.
Mm-mm.
He's going there because he's troubled with his life.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Moses is in Horeb not to meet with the angel. He's running away from Pharaoh.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The 20th century Moses.
Yes.
We're showing you
Amen.
That he's the same prophet.
Amen.
That's why he gave a prophecy.
Amen.
The Lord your God.
Yes.
Shall raise up a prophet like an unto me.
Amen.
That was in the first Exodus.
Amen.
Jesus comes in the second Exodus.
Amen.
But Jesus is cut off in the midst of the week.
Yes.
He says, the Son of Man,
Amen.
Hallelujah,
yes.
Shall be revealed in that day.
Amen.
By who? By a Son of Man.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So he's got to come in the spirit of Moses.
Praise the Lord.
With the same characteristics.
Praise the Lord.
So we have to watch the Bible characteristics of the Old Testament so that we can see.
My God.
Who is this man?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
In Greensmill, he says, I'm here. Moses had killed a man. When he met this angel didn't speak anything about Moses' past.
My God.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I am here to explain.
Yeah.
Why you left Egypt?
Yeah.
Hallelujah!
Praise
you didn't leave Egypt to be a shepherd of Jethro's sheep.
Yeah.
You didn't leave Egypt to just come and marry Zipporah.
Yeah.
You didn't leave Egypt just to perish in the wilderness.
No.
There is a commission.
Amen.
There is a commissioning in the mountain.
Yes.
Hallelujah!
Praise
that angel that brings the commission. That angel is not a man.
Praise
that angel is God himself.
Yes.
Manifested in a form.
Praise
that you might not know. Sometimes he comes as the pillar of fire. Sometimes he comes as a man. Sometimes he comes as a cloud. Sometimes he comes just as a wind. But he's the same God.
Praise the Lord.
The angel.
My.
Hallelujah.
Wonderful.
He started explaining to him his misunderstood life.
Praise the
he
Lord.
He said there is a people that believed the commission in its infancy.
Praise.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amram and Yashobet, they believed that this child is a deliverer. They had not seen him open the Red Sea yet. They had not seen him speak flies into existence yet. They had not seen any miracle. But they say, we are willing to risk our lives for this little child.
Yes.
Catching the revelation
Amen.
Of the deliverer
Praise the Lord.
In its infancy.
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Hey.
Just like Simeon. Who said, I'm not going to die until I see the Lord's Christ.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
And he took the child in his hands and blessed him. He said, this is the Messiah.
Praise the Lord.
He had not seen him bring Lazarus forth. He had not seen him opening eyes of the blind. He had not seen him resurrect yet. But he believed the commission.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
You've got to believe this message.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
You've got to believe the commission of the bride.
Praise the Lord.
Because the commission does not end with Revelation 10:7.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Revelation 10:8 goes to check the book.
All right.
Eat the book and become the book.
Yes, sir.
But can you believe the commission?
Praise the Lord.
In
Amen.
Its infancy.
My Amen. God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Before I have spoken limbs into existence.
Praise the Lord.
Before HIV has been healed in your midst.
Praise the
before
Lord.
Before you have seen the miraculous.
Praise
can
the
you
Lord.
Believe
hey.
The commission in its infancy?
Praise yeah. the Lord.
That's why real believers are made.
Correct, amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
To believe that you are going to be delivered.
Praise the Lord.
You are going to be saved. You are going to be healed.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Before he has done anything in your life yet.
Wonderful.
Hallelujah.
They believe.
Powerful.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The Bible says, and the Lord said,
yeah.
I have surely seen the affliction of my people, which are in Egypt, and have heard their cry by reason of their taskmasters. For I know their sorrows. This is God who is heard the people's cry. He said, and I am come down to deliver. Who is the deliverer?
My God.
Hallelujah.
Praise
who is the angel that is going down to Egypt to deliver the children of Israel?
Yes.
Remember, we are a type of Israel.
Praise the Lord.
Israel was a nation within a nation.
Amen.
A nation in Egypt.
Amen.
You and me, a nation in the denominations.
Amen.
But God has sent down a deliverer. And this deliverer is God himself coming down.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
It's not Moses.
Powerful.
Moses is not the deliverer.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He just finds the nearest body.
Yeah.
To identify with.
Amen.
As he embarks on the journey of delivery.
Yes, sir. Praise the Lord. That's right. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So to disrespect the messenger is to disrespect the angel.
Yes. Correct. Amen.
Because the angel
Amen.
Is the one that has commissioned the messenger.
Correct. Amen.
Amen.
Michael.
Hallelujah.
The angel is doing the delivering in the messenger.
Correct. Amen.
Amen.
Glory!
Hey.
He says, out of the land of Egypt, and to bring them up out of that land unto a good land, and large, unto a land flowing with milk and honey, unto the place of the Canaanites, and the Hittites, and the Amorites, and the Perizzites, and the Hivites, and the Jebusites. Now therefore, behold, the cry of the children of Israel is come unto me. And I have also seen the oppression wherewith the Egyptians oppress them. Come now, therefore, I will send thee hand to Pharaoh, and thou mayest bring forth my people, the children of Israel, out of Egypt. Mm-hmm. And Moses said unto God,
praise the Lord.
Who am I? Mm-hmm. You've got to, he didn't understand himself.
Mm-hmm.
Who am I? What's so special about me? Amen.
Amen.
Who am I?
Amen.
Who am I that I should go unto Pharaoh and that I should bring forth the children of Israel out of Egypt?
Amen.
And he said, certainly I will be with thee.
Amen.
And this shall be a token unto thee that I have sent thee.
Amen.
When thou hast brought forth the children out of Egypt, ye shall serve God upon this mountain. This is God giving the commission. You shall serve God upon this mountain. And then and Moses said unto God, behold, when I come unto the children of Israel,
my God.
He has been already told, I'm the God of Abraham. I'm the God of Jacob. I'm the God of Isaac. He says, but when I get there, what should I tell them?
Amen.
What shall I say unto them? The God of your fathers, he has sent me unto you. He's asking them. I've heard that part.
Mm.
Says, but they shall say unto me, what is his name?
Mm.
I want you to understand now.
Praise the Lord.
The revelation of the name of God
Amen.
In the dispensation
is what places the position of the messenger. Because the messenger cannot be effective with the commission if he doesn't know the name of God revealed in that dispensation.
Amen.
Amen. Hey. That's right.
Hey.
Amen.
Amen.
God reveals himself in different names.
Amen. Right.
On different dispensations.
Hey.
Yes, sir.
When he created the realm,
yes,
he was not Jehovah Rapha.
Hey. Mm.
He was Jehovah Jireh.
That's right.
The Lord that provides.
Yes, sir.
When he raised up a serpent in the wilderness,
hey,
and when they would be bitten by snakes,
hey,
and they are sick and they would look and leave, he was Jehovah Rapha, the Lord that heals.
Amen.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Amen.
When they were weak and shaken, and they were so weak and nobody could help them, they were without strength, he gave them milk, they nest from him. He was Jehovah El Shaddai, the double-breasted one. So God is revealing himself in different names, in different dispensations, and in different circumstances. So he says, I want to know the name.
Hey. Yeah,
but here God gives a name,
hey,
yeah,
that covers all dispensations.
Hey.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Hi, Paul.
Hallelujah.
Like that.
Says, and they say, what is his name? What shall I say unto thee?
Mm.
I want you to see. And God said unto Moses, I am that I am.
Yeah.
God reveals his name.
Yeah.
The full name.
Yes. Hey.
To Moses.
Amen.
He says, I am that I am.
Mm.
But,
yeah,
I want you to see. And he said, this is God. He first tells him the full name.
Amen.
In the full names, there is two I ams.
Amen.
He says, I am that I am.
Yes.
And he said, thus shalt thou say unto the children of Israel.
That's right.
Don't tell them that I am that I am.
Yeah.
You show them the other parts,
yes,
of the I am.
Yes.
Tell them that I am has sent me.
Amen.
The other I am was veiled in Moses.
Yes.
Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
From this moment onwards,
amen,
it's no longer Moses.
Yes,
it's the I am.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The angel leading from before and leading from within.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
When he was in Pharaoh's palace,
amen,
they didn't see the pillar of fire.
Amen.
The I am was speaking from within Moses.
Yes. Amen.
Let there be.
Yes.
Let there be.
Amen.
Let there be.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They say, is this not Moses?
Yes.
Our brother.
Amen.
Is this not Moses?
Yes.
Who killed an Egyptian?
Amen.
Is this not Moses?
Amen.
Who is a runaway prophet?
Amen.
Is this not Moses?
Amen.
The illegitimate son of Pharaoh?
Amen.
No, sir. It was no longer Moses.
Amen.
Because the angel of the Lord was with him.
Yes.
Outside they would see the pillar of fire. But there was the other part of the I am. God was veiled in the 16 elements of man.
Hey.
God there to speak things. It was not Moses. They are squirrels. The only creator is God. There are flies that were created in Genesis. But there are flies that were created by Moses.
Yes.
Amen.
There are frogs that were created in Genesis.
Yes.
But there are frogs that were created by Moses.
Yes. All right.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
The angel of the Lord, the creating angel, speaking things into existence.
Amen.
If you cannot see him, then you can easily disrespect the messenger.
Amen.
Because
Amen.
You have no understanding.
That's right.
No
difference. Amen.
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 Let's go to, again, Exodus 23 from verses 20. It says, Exodus 23, verses 20. Behold, I send an angel before
Amen.
Thee to keep thee in the way and to bring thee into a place which I have prepared. Beware of him and obey his voice. Provoke him not. What kind of an angel is this? You should not provoke this angel, for he will not pardon you. A pardoning angel.
Mm-hmm.
An angel that comes with forgiveness. When the prophet went up on Mount Sunset, Seven angels came down. He says the seventh one was more notable unto me.
Yes, sir.
He says he is the seventh seal.
Amen.
He's the one that handed him the book. Mm. He's the one that held that entire revelation of them seven seals. Hallelujah!
Amen.
And after that, he says, now I can come and preach the message of marriage and divorce.
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
And in the message of marriage and divorce, he was not preaching polygamy.
Amen.
No, sir!
Amen.
He said, there's many of you that have been married 2-3 times. Some of you have been divorced and living in a haphazard way.
Yes.
He says what? I forgive you.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
Provoke him not!
Yes, sir.
For he will not pardon you.
Amen.
Who is forgiving sins?
Praise the Lord.
Who is forgiving sins?
My mind.
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Powerful.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Sister Mary, you said we want those things under the pot. These are the things under
yes,
the pot.
Yes, amen.
Who is forgiving sins?
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Marriage and divorce. Many people don't even want to say marriage and divorce on the pulpit.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Who is coming?
Yeah.
He's showing the first covenants.
Yes, sir.
Sex by polygamy. He's showing them through the church.
Amen.
He's showing them. Showing them David and many wives. He's showing them a bull and many cows and all that.
Yes, sir.
And then he comes. He says, "Wait."
Yeah.
Wait till the end of the service.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
If you
Amen.
Left before he finished, yes, you'd go out and start preaching polygamy.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the message
Amen.
Is coming at the end of the message.
Amen.
Just like the messenger
Amen.
Comes at the end of the age.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you stood up before you finished the message of marriage and divorce, you'd go with an idea that polygamy is permissible.
Mm.
But at the end, he says, brothers,
yes, sir.
It wasn't so from the beginning.
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Yes.
God created the male and female, one.
Yes.
Hallelujah!
Yes.
But I say unto you,
Amen.
That believe my message.
Yes.
Whose message?
Amen.
The angel's message.
Amen.
Amen.
If you have done it, don't do it no more.
Yes,
I forgive you.
Praise Amen. The Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He won't pardon your transgressions.
Yes, sir.
But this angel comes down with a pardon.
My God.
He's bringing forgiveness.
Yes. Amen.
He's giving a way of escape.
Wonderful.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
It says, for my name is in him.
Mm-hmm.
But if thou shalt indeed obey his voice,
mm-hmm.
I want you to see now. Obeying his voice, there is two things that is happening here.
Yeah.
Moses is taking out the children of Israel. He's given two signs. One of the signs, put your hand. When you take it out, you shall see leprosy. The other sign, put your stick on the ground. It changes into a snake. Hold it by the tail.
Yeah.
It becomes a stick again. Two signs he is given by God. That you've got the power to bring the plagues upon the people.
Yeah.
And you've got the power in the stick to open closed situations.
Amen.
Two signs is given to the 20th century Moses.
Praise
you can
Lord.
Descend the hearts of the people.
Amen.
By touching them by the hand, you can detect the diseases that they have. Discernment and divine healing was
Amen.
Given to the prophet. Two signs.
Yes. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the angel talks about the two signs in the commissioning of the messengers.
Correct. Amen.
But when he watches the obedience of the messengers,
he
brings the third unspoken sign, which
Amen.
Is the third pool.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
The voice behind the signs.
Yes, sir. Praise the Lord.
That's what right. makes a difference.
Yes.
Everybody can, because the signs that Moses had, they were impersonable. When Moses let down his stick and changed into a snake, Jannes and Jambres did the same thing.
Amen.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Amen.
They could mimic the very thing.
Correct.
That Amen. Moses was doing.
Oh my.
When Brother Branham touched people and said, I see you've got cancer. Within no time, the Pentecostals were doing it.
Yes, sir.
When Brother Branham would descend and tell a person his address, today we've got people that does that.
Correct. Amen.
Impersonable signs. But the voice behind the sign, which is the third sign.
Correct. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
The ecclesiastical Egyptian voices.
My God. Powerful. Praise the Lord.
In the voice of God in the wilderness.
Amen.
God taking through them the stages.
Yes, sir. Praise
Hallelujah. Mm. Of grace. Mm. Mm. Egypt passing through the Red Sea. That was baptism. Mm. And then God puts them in the wilderness. Sanctification. Mm. Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
First he takes them out of Egypt. Mm. In the wilderness he's taking Egypt out of them.
Mm. Hallelujah. Amen. That's right.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
We take you first out of the denominations. But if we do not take the denominations out of you, you still have the ecclesiastical denominational voice.
Yes.
Ringing in your head. Amen. You want to go into the promised word.
My God.
They wanted to enter in the promised land with Egyptian mindsets.
Oh my.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
And God said, no sir. There's another junction. Kadesh Barnea.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Separation time.
Amen.
Exposition time.
Amen.
Manifestation time. Amen. You can't want to believe this message with a denominational filter. Hallelujah! Amen. You need a thinking man's filter and a holy man's taste.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Filter the things of the world. Amen. Filter the denominational way of believing. Amen. Believe the message the way it's supposed to be believed.
Amen.
And in the wilderness, that's where the manifestation of carnalness is shown. In the wilderness, that's where the fleshly desired, the desires and the unconvertedness is made manifest. They started saying, we want garlic. We want flesh. We're sick and tired of eating manna. What is it? We're in the dispensation of the wilderness. People have come out of denominations. They're in the message now.
Yes.
This is the time where God is taking the world out of you. He's calling the bride out of the bride, a nation out of a nation.
Amen.
And you want to worship God in your own prescription. Mm-hmm. I want to dress the way I want to dress. Mm-hmm. I want to talk the way I want to talk. Mm-hmm. I want to behave the way I want to behave. But yet still I want to get into the promised land. Forget.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen.
There is no promise of the rapture. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
To a person that doesn't want to worship according to the voice of the generation.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And in the wilderness. That's where Moses goes up the mountain.
Amen.
To come down with the message.
Amen.
The revealed word.
Correct.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. And
down there, the ministers are already into idolatry.
My God.
Idol worship. In the wilderness.
Praise the Lord.
The man that has been ordained to be the fivefold ministry, Aaron the high priest.
Amen.
And the people, they have already built a golden calf.
My God.
The message of the hour is still coming. Yes. The prophet says, look on this.
Amen.
He said, but when I was going west, I looked through the corner of my eye. I saw the brothers drifting away already.
Yes. That's right.
This is the generation.
Correct. Amen.
This is the time.
Amen.
Where people want to worship God with their own idea.
My God.
Can I preach?
Correct. Yes. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We have never had so many questions. Like we have in this generation.
Amen.
What should we do about this? What should we do about that? What should we do about all the questions leading to compromise?
Yes, sir. Gospel truth.
What's the difference between a screen without a TV card and a screen with a TV card? What's the difference? Television sends you to hell.
Yes, sir.
Desensitized. You are eating directly.
Yes, sir.
From the tree of the knowledge of good and evil.
Yes, sir. Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Yes. We're living in a generation where people ask, how high is the high heel? What should I do to my hair? How should it look? What's the acceptable way? You want to go into the rapture with the denominational filter? There's no rapture for you.
Praise the Lord.
There's no promise of the rapture.
Correct. Amen.
My wife knows it. She comes with these funny stories of issues of hair. Can I do this? I say, my sister, keep your hair natural.
Yes. Praise the Lord.
That's my conviction.
Amen.
I'm preaching as a pastor.
Praise the Lord.
Keep your hair natural.
Amen.
If you want to put things good, if your husband allows it, that's fine. He will answer for that.
Amen.
But I will answer supernatural here.
Yes, amen.
If breaking is doing this, it still breaks even under the wind. When you come into breaks,
amen.
In breaks, don't do things while you're looking at magazines. Don't look at the television. Don't look at other people. Also, you mean the whole church? The church in such a place, are they all going to hell? I don't know.
Hallelujah.
I preach what I've been given.
Amen.
Comes to me with weave and high heels and a short skirt and say, I come from the presence of the Lord. I say, depart from me, you are cursed. There's no angel like that.
Amen.
Says, there goes a real Christian woman.
Amen.
Godly dressed, properly handled.
Amen.
Says, Christians.
Amen.
Christians, they're natural anyway.
Amen.
You know, it's in a woman to look beautiful. He says, but don't look like the world.
Yes. Amen.
If you have got problems with your hair, if it's real soft, maybe you can come, we talk. Then we advise one another.
Mm. Yes.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Amen. Praise the Lord.
But people are running after the things of the world.
Mm.
A denominational filter.
Mm.
Brothers borderline.
Mm.
They've got ungodly relationships with women out there.
Yes.
Calling them friends.
Mm.
She's my friend. Your friend is your wife.
Come on.
But she's my friend. How we talk with her. You laugh more with her than you do with your wife.
Come on.
You want to make it to the rapture? And you go around testifying and say, the Lord is about to come.
Hey.
Are you in a rapturable condition?
Come on, brother.
This is the wilderness.
Yes. Yes.
This is the message of Moses.
Yes.
Can we have panic? Can we have a little bit of compromise? Can we have tea parties? No tea parties.
Yes, sir.
Maybe.
We're going to have all nights.
Yes.
We're going to pray. We're going to come to church.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Yes. Yes.
Say amen, somebody.
Amen.
We want to go to heaven.
Yes.
We don't want to play with each other.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'd rather have people say you were too hard on judgment day.
Yes.
Than to say you lied to us.
Amen.
Pastor, you are a liar. The prophet says they'll be blacking out. The pastors, on that day, there will be blood gushing. Pastors will be embarrassed. And the most disappointed man is the religious fellow.
Yes, sir. Yes. That's right.
The one that thought he was doing it the right way.
Correct, amen.
Lord,
amen.
The mercy.
I believe. Praise the Lord.
We're in the journey now.
Mm.
We're in the journey now.
Mm.
Where the word of God has got to live in your hearts.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
I could preach healing. I can preach things that excite you.
Mm.
I can make you receive your heart's desires.
Yes.
We all want that.
Amen.
You want things to change, you've got to change.
Yes, sir.
Change begins with you. As individuals.
Amen.
20th century.
Yes.
Moses is coming with an exodus. An exodus is a type of redemption. Going out of and getting into. That's why there's the third stage of the journey, the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Mm.
A lot of you stay too long in the cleansing part.
Mm.
The word is cleansing you,
mm.
but your heart is not filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
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 And you stay too long there. Oh, Pastor, I'm a believer. I love this message.
Mm.
I've left this. I've left my girlfriends. So did the watchtowers. They don't have girlfriends.
Yes, sir.
So not having girlfriends is not a right for you to... Oh, Pastor, I dress so well. So the Roman Catholic sisters, they dress so well.
Mm.
Amen.
Amen.
So that's not it. That's not... Yeah, oh, Pastor, I'm keeping my hair natural. So does the Mwasha Church.
Amen.
They're keeping their hair natural.
Mm.
They even have it covered.
Mm.
You see what I'm saying?
Amen.
The scripture says, he's given unto you. I don't know why I'm coming back to this
point. Praise the Lord.
Yeah, he's given unto you here for a covering.
Yes.
Not
yes.
something else.
Amen.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Praise
amen.
The Lord.
Sisters, amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
It's given unto her for that purpose, for that reason, for us to get into the resurrection of the rapture.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
But at Kadesh Barnea, God had given a promise. He said, these people, because they have not listened unto me, all of them shall perish.
Mm.
And Moses negotiated.
Mm.
He said, Father, if you make them perish. And the prophet said, I always wondered, how can men talk to God and tell God that you cannot destroy these people?
Mm.
You see? And it looked like God had changed his mind.
Mm.
Because he says, I'm going to destroy them.
Mm.
But the Bible says, once his word has gone forth,
all right.
It will not return void.
Yes.
But it will accomplish that which he has purposed it for.
Amen.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
At Kadesh Barnea, they all perished.
Correct. Amen.
Every one of them that was in disbelief, they all perished.
Mm.
The one that hit the rock and those that drank from the waters.
Mm.
So can a woman preach? Yes, she can.
Mm.
But yeah. She may not. That's what the scripture says.
Yes, yeah.
When the Bible says thou shalt not, it does not mean you can't. You can.
Mm.
They can even preach better than us. Mm. But the Paul comes and says, I suffer not a woman to preach, not to usurp authority.
Amen.
That is Paul speaking.
Yes.
You see what I'm saying?
Amen.
And then you come and say, but women are preaching and people are being healed.
Mm.
Women are preaching and people are being delivered.
Amen.
That's like Moses being told, speak to the rock.
Mm.
Moses takes the stick and he hits the rock.
Mm. Amen.
And God says, because thou hast disbelieved me,
amen.
You that has hit the rock, you shall see the promised land,
amen.
But you shall not enter therein.
Amen.
And those that drank the waters of disbelief.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
That's right.
So do it your way. But you perish your way.
Amen.
That is the teaching of the wilderness.
Correct.
The second part of the work of grace, sanctification.
Praise the Lord.
God working in his bride, showing whom he wants her to be in a condition that she can go and inherit. And he said, now the generation that was born in the wilderness, they are the ones that went in and fought the giants. And out of 2 million, that's one in a million, Joshua and Caleb, the believer and the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
They are the ones that go into the promised land.
Yeah.
The believer and the Holy Ghost were showing Joshua, positionally placing the people.
Hallelujah.
Ephraim, you should be there. Manasseh, you should be there.
Amen.
This one, you should be there. We are not taking charge. We are not taking our position. We are not taking what God said we are.
Amen.
Our rightful position. You cannot come and claim possession when you don't have the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
You cannot come and claim position. You can't say, I want to be adopted. From sanctification, you don't go to adoption. From sanctification, you go to the baptism of the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And from the Holy Ghost, you then come to adoption. Now you're a son in position. Do you see what I'm saying?
Amen.
Amen. Thou shalt not bow down to their gods, 24, nor serve them, nor do their works, but thou shalt utterly overthrow them. So don't be converted, be converters.
Mm-hmm.
But thou shalt utterly overthrow them and quite break down their images, and he shall serve the Lord your God, and he shall bless thy bread and thy water, and I will take sickness away from the midst of thee. These are people that are called by his name.
Amen.
Remember we said name the other time. I want you to understand this thing. I want to say it soft without preaching so that you can catch it. I spoke about Abraham.
Mm.
Abraham is a type of William Branham.
Mm.
Abraham was a father of many nations, naturally. William Branham is a father of many nations, spiritually.
Mm.
When he crosses over beyond the curtain of time, he sees people gathered in different places. He says, are all these Branhams?
Mm.
He says, no, these are your converts.
Mm.
That's his seed, spiritually.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see what I'm saying? Abraham meets Melchizedek. Branham speaks about who is this Melchizedek.
Amen.
Abraham sees Elohim.
Amen.
William Branham unveils who is Elohim and his condescendants until he is being made manifest even in the bride.
Amen.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Amen.
It's a direct parallel. Abraham seeks after a city whose maker and builder is God. William Branham goes to that city.
Yes,
and he sees the mansions that God has created. He sees hope in a mansion. He sees his daughter, Cheryl Rose, in a mansion. He sees that old sister that was 90 when he led her to the Lord in a mansion. He sees the city that Abraham was looking for. Do you see what I'm saying?
Amen.
So here we're seeing that Abraham is the same man. I wanted to talk about the thigh. Is the same man that commissions Eleazar and say, put your hand on my thigh.
Mm.
Thigh is the soft word of loins.
Mm. Amen.
You know, when the Bible speaks about certain things, it speaks about these things in disguise.
Mm.
Like it tells you that, and Saul went into the cave to cover his feet.
Mm.
It's talking about something mysterious.
Amen, that's right.
It tells you that, Uriah, you should go back to to wash your wife's feet.
Yes.
That is not feet washing. Uh-huh. It's talking about something else.
Correct.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Yes.
It says, and Eve ate of the fruit.
Yes.
You see? And then afterwards you hear that she conceived a child. So it's, the eating is not eating of apples. It's talking about something hidden.
Yes.
So when it's saying, touch my thigh, it's not just talking about a natural thigh.
Yes.
It's talking about the loins.
Amen.
Do you see? And then that name, that's why God says, and that name, that mystery name.
Yes, sir.
He says, and he wrote it on their foreheads.
Amen.
What name? The name of God is not being written on our foreheads.
Amen.
The mystery name of who we are. That's, now, if we are talking about thigh as loins, that means the name, the loins of God are the, is the mind of God.
Praise the Lord. Correct. Amen.
It's the mind of God.
Amen.
Because for us to be express attributes of God, we have to have been in his loins.
Yes.
And the only loins we were is we were in God's thoughts.
Yes.
So we become the attribute of God.
Amen.
That is spoken in our dispensation.
Correct. Yes. Amen.
In our time.
Mm.
So I am the attribute of God.
Mm.
But the one that you meet, the outside, is the one that you relate to.
Mm-hmm.
But with time, according to the word, the opening of the seal calls us and help us to see our name in the book.
Yes.
To see the mystery name of our DNA.
Amen.
Our relationship with God.
Amen.
That's the opening of the seventh seal.
Correct.
Is you being able to see your name in the book.
Correct.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Amen.
That's why William Branham, after preaching so many years, he says, in that day, I realized that I am not the son of Charles and Ella Branham.
Yes.
Do you see what I'm saying?
Yes.
When Charles and Ella Branham came together, they managed to create the outside man.
Amen.
But the inside man was the attribute of God.
Amen.
The one that was on the thigh of God.
Correct.
The one that was on the mind of Elohim.
Amen.
The one that is being expressed in time.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when I look at this picture, I am not seeing a man.
Yes, sir.
I am seeing two angels.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I am seeing the attribute of God.
Yes, sir.
Expressed in time.
Yes.
And I'm seeing the angel of the Lord.
Yes.
That is making the attribute of God.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This light here is being influenced with this light here.
Correct.
Though this light is the one that is dominating the picture.
Correct.
The one that we worship is this one.
Yes.
Not this one.
Yes.
This one. The Lord himself.
Amen.
The pillar of fire.
Amen.
In this generation.
Amen.
He decides to be taken a picture.
Correct. Amen.
In this generation.
Yes.
He decides to come in the midst of the people.
Amen.
One sister was praying. And she wanted healing. And this light, not this man, this light, left the picture.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It left the picture.
Amen.
And it went unto her. And it operated. It was Brother Babes in prison.
Yes.
While he was in prison,
yes, sir.
He started giving them spoken words.
Mm.
And he gave them that church edge where it had the picture of the prophet
with
the pillar of fire in black and white.
Yes, sir.
This man had a crooked spine.
Correct.
These are thugs. These are people that are in maximum prison.
Yes. Yes.
They don't have any conviction.
Yeah.
Brother, that man was sitting.
He correct.
Reading the spoken word.
Amen.
He opened the page where the picture of the prophet was. And he saw something. And then he crossed the page.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
And then he said, hey,
something
is happening here.
Yeah.
So he started opening it slowly. And he saw that light. It's shining there.
Yeah.
Yeah. He starts screaming in the prison cells now. Something is happening here. He opens that page. The light leaves the page.
Yes.
Goes to his spine.
Yeah.
And heals his spine.
Yes.
Hallelujah. And the prison was converted.
Amen.
Until when there were riots, Brother Babes would be called to come and count down the riots in prison, because the prison guards were not able to control it.
Hallelujah.
It was not Brother Babes.
Yes.
It was this light.
Yes.
Controlling.
Yes.
Governing the people.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
The same light
yes.
that led the children of Israel out of Egypt under the Moses Commission. We had a Moses in this generation.
Hallelujah.
Then Moses has left the scene, but the light is still here. It is still with us. The angel of God, not seen for 2,000 years, is appearing. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. He's here physically.
Hallelujah.
He's here healing people. Hallelujah.
Yes,
when we lay people, when we lay our hands, it's not us that does the healing. It's the angel of the Lord. It's the Lord himself. Hallelujah. I have come down to explain your misunderstood life. Oh, my. It did not end with the prophet.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Behold. That is Revelation 10:1.
Yes,
I, behold, yes. I, Revelation 10:1,
yes.
Send you, Revelation 10:8-11.
Yes,
Elijah, Revelation 10:7, the prophet to come and restore you, to turn the hearts of the children. That's Revelation 3:4.
Yes.
When the lion roars, seven thunders utter their voices.
Amen.
What is it? The coming down of the angel of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He has come down.
That's correct, amen.
To right to the door. To us an explanation.
Amen. About our praise the Lord.
Many a times we don't know who we are.
Amen.
But that's why the angel came down.
Amen. Praise
Many
the Lord.
Many times people look at this and they say the picture of Brother Branham.
Mm.
It's not just Brother Branham.
Praise the Lord.
God himself.
Amen.
Decided to take a selfie.
Amen.
This photograph was taken.
Mm.
By the FBI.
Yes, sir.
They started testing it. It's written here.
Mm.
They put it and tested it.
Correct.
They checked it against UV light and other form of infrared lights.
Mm.
And they realized there was no external source of light.
Mm.
But the halo was shining from within itself.
Yeah.
And they say the mechanical eye of the camera cannot take psychology.
Yes.
Hallelujah! This is not psychology.
Yes.
This is God himself.
Yes.
Come down in this generation.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. In the evening time, praise God.
Hallelujah.
Around that evening time,
yeah.
Revealing himself to a people. Hallelujah.
Right.
Oh my. That was the evening time. Amen. And he said, Shalom. It's the rising of the sun.
Hallelujah.
And when it's daylight,
Amen.
We are not led by the cloud.
Amen.
We are not led by the light. We are led by the cloud.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's start. 1963, 28 February. Hallelujah.
Praise
this picture was taken.
Yes.
They didn't know what this thing was. You see, this is the ground. This is Sunset Mountain.
Praise
we
the Lord.
Have read about Mount Sinai.
Yes.
We have read about Mount Zion. We have heard about Mount Calvary.
Amen.
There is a mountain in this generation. Mount Sunset.
Amen.
Hallelujah. When the sun is setting, the sun is rising also. It's the rising of the sun. Not the S-O-N. Not the S-U-N. But the S-O-N.
Hallelujah.
And it stood like this for a long time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
On April the 7th. Hallelujah!
Lord.
1965,
yes.
April the 7th.
Yeah.
God says, you have been looking at this thing
Amen.
The wrong,
yes.
the wrong way for a long time.
Praise the Lord.
Turn
it
around to the right. Hallelujah!
Lord.
Where should you turn the picture to?
Amen.
Turn the picture to the right.
Amen.
And where is he looking? Do you see his eyes?
Yes.
Do you see his nose?
Amen.
Can you see his mouth?
Amen.
Hallelujah! Where is he looking?
Yeah.
He's looking towards the right.
Yes.
Which thief did he pattern on the cross?
Yeah,
right. The thief on the right.
Yeah.
It's time that you turn your picture.
Yeah.
The picture of your life is being turned by the message.
Yeah.
We are no longer looking at this, the denominational way.
Yeah.
We are no longer looking at this message, the church way.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
We are not just a message people,
yeah.
but we are real believers.
Yeah.
This is my Lord. Come down in this generation
yes.
with a wig upon his head.
Yes.
Seven angels came down.
Yes.
Hallelujah!
Yes.
Showing the book of Judges.
Yes.
Hallelujah!
Yes.
He's coming down as a judge. And after the book of Judges, which book follows? the book of Ruth. Hallelujah! After he has come as a judge, the next ministry is the ministry of the bride, being united with Boaz. And after that is the book of Samuel, which speaks about David, the reigning of David, which is the millennium reign. Hallelujah! We are in a dispensation.
Amen.
That's right. Praise the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We've been called.
Correct. Amen.
To something higher.
Amen.
Let's stand upon our feet.
My God.
Amen. The angel of the Lord is here.
Yes.
God is not identifying himself with the people that are trying to preach an eloquent message, a skilled message, a message with just words, with repetition of cultures of the message. But it's coming to a people that have seen the revelation on the white stone. He's coming to a people to identify himself with those that are moving with the cloud, with those that are moving into the union of Ruth and Boaz. Hallelujah! The book of Esther comes between Nehemiah and Job.
Amen.
Nehemiah is the returning of the children of Israel to rebuild the walls of Jerusalem.
Amen.
Nehemiah is the six trumpets.
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
In the book of Esther is the queen coming to be united with Ahasuerus,
yes,
the king himself. And after that, the book of Job is the book of the resurrection.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah!
Amen.
So there are only two books that are symbolized by the woman.
Amen.
One comes in as a bride.
Mm.
Amen.
Amen.
Wife of Boaz, a gentle bride.
Amen.
Being married to Boaz.
Amen.
Amen. To the husbandman himself.
Amen.
Amen. And then we see in Esther, we see a queen. She's coming in as a queen at the time where people are about to be destroyed. That is you and me. We're in the season.
Hallelujah.
Where we're being united.
Amen.
With Ahasuerus. Because Vashti, the denominational wife, the denominational queen, she has made her own feast. She has called her own prophets. She said, I don't want to play before the king. I don't want to entertain the king. But you and me, the things I am preaching,
amen,
the things I am telling you,
amen,
hallelujah,
amen,
your attitude,
amen,
determines whether you want to entertain the king or not.
Amen.
Let's bow our heads. If you're here, you're saying, Lord, remember me in this dispensation.
Amen.
Remember me in this time. Lord, I need to have a relationship with you. The time for church is over.
Amen.
The time for just coming, filling a pew, going back home. It's time to ponder and to think upon these things.
Amen.
We have got to start coming into the image of the Word.
Amen.
Otherwise, we are not going to be able to overcome the world out there. The sickness in you can be overcome by the power that is already in you. In every person, God has put healing inside of
us.
Amen. I see hands all over the building. Heavenly Father, Almighty God, we come before your throne of grace tonight. We thank you because you are life. We thank you because you are grace. We thank you because you are the giver of it and giver of eternal life. Dear God, we thank you tonight that you have brought such a message.
Yes, ma'am.
Father, showing us the presence of that angel.
Yes, ma'am.
The messenger. That's why you said the message and the messenger is one. Lord God Almighty, it's you that came down to preach these things to us.
Yes.
It's you that came and revealed the seals to us.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Father, we don't see Brother Branham,
yes, ma'am,
but we see God in Brother Branham. We see the God that came down and could descend the hearts of men like you did in the day of Abraham. We see the same God, Almighty Jesus Christ, that could speak things into existence when you spoke those squirrels in this generation. Father, we don't want to overlook that. Father, may our confession match with our character. May our life, Lord, speak about this message.
Yes.
May it reflect it, oh God.
Amen.
May we mean it from our hearts. Father, may it be a conviction,
yes,
not just a conversion.
Amen.
Father, let it not be something that we've been persuaded to do.
Yes.
But Father, let every one of us, from brother to sister to the young ones,
yes,
Father, have a personal conviction upon
yes,
this message.
Amen, Lord.
That they may walk
yes,
in thy statutes. That they may live the way you want them to live.
Amen.
That they may talk according to the way you want them to talk. I pray, Father, for your grace.
Amen.
I pray, Father, for your mercy. I pray, dear God, that you deliver them.
Thank you,
that are in need of deliverance.
Amen.
I pray that you enlighten them that have got so many questions.
Amen.
I pray that you direct their path.
Yes.
Lord Jesus Christ, in every one of their endeavors. Lord Jesus Christ, forgive them, Lord, that don't know you yet, that continue to err before you. Have mercy upon us, Lord Jesus. Father, and look at us not according to our own works, but through the shed blood of Jesus Christ. May the pardon come to us. We thank you, Father, for this church. We thank you for those that are here and them that are not in our place. Father, I am praying for them. I remember them tonight, Lord, knowing that, oh God, the pending dangers, the signs of the time, are everywhere, Lord.
Yes.
Russia is preparing for war.
Yes.
America is ready for a woman president.
Yes.
Lord Jesus Christ, reports are coming every day. Los Angeles has to sink.
Yes.
Almighty God, where shall our hearts be?
Yes.
Where shall we stand, oh God? We thank you for the messenger that you have sent.
Yes.
Father, may we open our open eyes that we may see your promise and live according to it. We need you more than anything else. We need you more than anything else, Lord. Have mercy upon us, Lord. We thank you, Lord Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen and amen.
Amen.
For the day of redemption
is near.
Messiah,
suffering for fear.
Hallelujah.
Be filled with the Spirit, oh, yes, stream and clear.
Oh, yes.
Look up, your redemption is near.
For the day,
because truth they are denying.
Amen.
That Jesus Christ, Jesus the Christ is our God.
Mm-hmm.
Through this generation, spans God's revelation.
Mm-hmm.
We will walk where the apostles have trod. Says the fig tree is growing. You know what the fig tree is? That is Israel. Jerusalem restoring. Says your national life long dethroned. You know the Islams, they have dethroned them for a long time, but she is now budding again.
Amen.
Amen. Says today she's calling. The latter rain is falling. Return, oh, disperse to your own. Jews are returning back to Israel for the final calling of the 144,000. And when you see that, know that the Gentile dispensation is closing. Amen. God richly bless you. That you may be seated. Amen. We'll meet on Sunday. Not this Sunday, but the following Sunday. Pastor Nigel will be preaching for us. Amen. He's been wanting to come. Amen. So I was with him yesterday, and he said, you know, I want to come. And so I said, no, you can come. You can even come this Sunday. He said, no, I'm still tired from the streets. I'll be coming next week. Amen. So let's just pray for the services. I believe we have a wonderful time. Amen. Let's also pray for this Sunday service. We're trusting God for something supernatural to take place. Amen. Let's pray for one another. Let's love one another. You're doing such a wonderful things. There's a lot of testimonies that is coming from our midst. You know, there's a proud person, it's me. I can see the glory of God living in church, you know. Even to those that can't make it on Thursday, you know, I communicate with them, some of them during the week, and you can just see that God is keeping them, God is taking care of them. We have now a WhatsApp group, you know, for announcements and things. So those that are not there and want to be there, you can give your numbers to Brother Nasha there. He's our admin. He's helping, you know, with adding people. And it's really blessing the saints. I see the brothers, they send also a quote, you know, at least a day. They just send something.
Right.
And that something really puts our hearts on fire. Amen. God richly bless you. Keep you is my prayer. Amen.
Amen.
I'm always praying for you. Please pray for me also.
Amen.
Pray for the pastors. Pray for Brazimon. Pray for Brazimba. Pray that for the preachers. You know, the devil is always attacking the leadership.
Amen.
So if the church can pray, then we can have victory with God.
Amen.
How many have been blessed?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Is it becoming tangible?
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Amen.
Amen.
Brother Donald, please come and dismiss us. Amen.
I'm not watching, 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 I'm not watching,